We can measure the speed of catalysis of enzymes, and we do so for a variety of reasons. We can measure the speed of unregulated enzymes to know, for example, which enzyme in a pathway is the slowest one, and to get an idea then of the overall rate of production of some product of a pathway. We can measure the speed of catalysis of allosterically regulated enzymes in the presence or absence of their allosteric effectors to see how much faster or slower an enzyme might work. We do all these things in part because there are good clinical or medical reasons to do so. Enzymes often malfunction because of disease from external factors like bacteria or even genetic factors. So here's why we study enzyme kinetics summarized. Viral and bacterial infection or environmental poisons could interfere with specific enzyme in a metabolic pathway, and if we don't know which one is involved, we would do enzyme kinetics on all of the enzymes in the pathway and identify the one that was causing the problem. Maybe we could come up with a therapy as a result. As I said, some genetic diseases result from mutations in the genes for enzymes that cause an immediate enzymatic problem. So knowing which reaction is involved is often a matter of identifying what is called the rate-limiting reaction in a pathway, the slowest reaction in a pathway. Let's start the process with a few observations here. We can determine the kinetics of a reaction in which substrate is converted to product by enzyme E in this manner. We have a bunch of test tubes, each with the same amount of enzyme dissolved in water, and we are now pipetting different amounts of substrate into each of those tubes, and we're going to measure how fast the substrate is converted to product in each tube. So here it is. We hold the enzyme constant while varying the substrate concentration in each tube, and we add the substrate, and we watch the conversion to product. Then we're going to measure the initial rate of the reaction at each substrate concentration, and we're going to plot the data. So here is the plot. At a low substrate concentration of 10 to the minus 5th molar, we get product formation over, we may measure it over, say, 2 minutes, and we get product formation that looks like this. If we double the concentration, so we use a concentration of substrate at 2 times 10 to the 5th molar, we get a faster production of product. If we use 4 times 10 to the 5th molar, we get even faster production of product, right? More product produced per second. If we use twice as much again, that is 8 times 10 to the minus 5th molar, we only get a very slight increase in the rate of product formation at each time point. And in fact, if you keep doubling the concentration of substrate, the curves don't get any higher. So the question is, why doesn't product formation increase at a faster rate when the substrate is larger than 4 times or bigger than 4 times 10 to the minus 5th molar? The answer is that an enzyme acts by virtue of its active site, and if you put a certain concentration of enzyme into solution, and remember the concentration of enzyme in each of the tubes in this experiment is the same, you can add more and more substrate, but at some point the enzyme becomes saturated with substrate. There's, in other words, so much substrate around that the enzyme is always loaded with substrate, and it can only catalyze the reaction at a maximal rate based on the number of enzyme molecules in the solution. We say the enzyme has become saturated with substrate.